Quale, nee. Quale, nee.
Yes, Slovenia's Leah is singing the song Vala, nee, no thank you. Should we talk about it?
Let's do this!
Je u tem, ne prodaj se u sam, to je na vrba se. Hvala ne, ne. Hvala ne. Hvala ne, ne.
Yes, Slovenia's Leja Skirk Cirk has beaten a lot of Eurovision returnees, a lot of fan favorites to win the day at EMA 2018 in Ljubljana. She is ready to drop it like it's hot in Lisbon. Deppin, what do you think?
I'm just thinking BQL. When is their day ever gonna come? Always the bridesmaid. Well, Leah, congratulations, you got the ticket, but you know what, you're still going into another competition, and the reality is, for me, this doesn't just cut it. Cool choreography, perhaps a really interesting hook, but I'm not really sold on the song or what the message is about. In a sea of 43 songs, this isn't at my top position, or near the top for me.
Okay, so here's the thing, when we first listened to them and when we first reacted, I wasn't that big a fan of the song, and now that I've watched it a couple times, it gets in your head, I think. It's like, that does like, nay, 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 yeah, no, that really has got in my head, and I really enjoy it now. I think that there's a... I'm not too confident about its chances at Eurovision, but I would quite like to see it in the final, actually. I think it brings something a bit different. I like the message. You know, it's kind of going a little bit Me Too movement-ish. Mm. You know, saying, no thanks, don't want, I can do this by myself. No, I really like it, and I like the staging. I just worry that maybe it comes across a bit too aggressive at times. And I'm still not a huge fan of, like, the drop after the chorus. It's just not something that I personally enjoy, but I've kind of grown to appreciate it a bit more in this song.
Vala, nay, nay, hey, hey, hey. I follow Leah on Instagram, y'all, and she has an adorable little daughter. She tucks her into bed. Then I hit play on this, and she's in leather, dropping it like it's hot, like she's a badass, gonna kick your ass. She contains multitudes, is the point. This woman can do many things. She's many things to many people, from mommy to disco queen. I love it. The staging in Slovenia was really quite excellent, I thought. They made the most of their resources. The floor was all psychedelic and crazy. She looked great. She had wackadoodle dancers screaming through fake windows. One of the best pre-choruses of Eurovision 2018.
What is it?
She's Slovenian. We don't speak it.
And it leads to one of the worst choruses of Eurovision 2018. But that's why I like it. Vala, nay, 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 nay. It reminds me of Nene Leakes from The Real Housewives of Atlanta. The point is, this is high impact. High impact, memorable. One could call this a hot mess. I say warm it up. Lisbon needs some more heat. And Leah is bringing it. Well done.
I would agree with the hot mess comment, but I love a hot mess. I love trash. She has got a great voice. She's got great stage presence. They did make a great performance, and it does build up to this great thing. But I do agree that when the beat drops, it just is a bit cringe. It's a bit like one of those songs where they release them. It's like hashtag too cool for you. And they like write up laps three, but they'll actually write the letters. Like, it's just a bit cringe trying to that. And it just doesn't come across very professional. No, professional is the wrong word, but it's just not cool, basically. And I think if they'd revamped that beat, they would have had a chance of having a chance to the final. I think their only chance now in getting to the final is if they do a sort of Katy Perry, is it called Dark Storm? That one where she's Egyptian.
Dark Horse.
Yeah. If they go all out with the staging, have her like sat on a throne, like lying on a bed, people carrying her, they could kind of trick the viewers into thinking this is something really high budget, something really impressive. But no, it's entertaining. And yeah, I mean, it's better than last year.
anything is.
I'll give him that.
All right, well, on that note, we should go around and say Vala Hey Hey with our score and whether we think this will qualify from the second?
Second, yeah.
Second semi-final, starting with Ed.
Right, I gave this a 7, and in terms of qualifying, it's a Chvala Nay from me, unless they go absolutely all out with that staging, like I said, fool the viewers into thinking this is a masterpiece.
I'm sorry, will you have to start using words like trick the viewers, fool the viewers, there's a drop chorus that isn't quite tying in. I'm sorry, this is below average. It sits at a 4 for me, a generous 4.
Oh, no. I've given it a 6.5. And I think that actually the staging, it's one of those stagings which actually no LEDs, obviously, in Lisbon. That might help it because that whole window thing really worked. That's my favourite bit of the staging, actually. Apart from that one backing dancer who fell over whilst trying to slut drop in the middle of the performance. But that happens. It's live TV. It happens, people. I enjoy it. I don't think it will qualify as much as I would love it to qualify, because I would love to see it on the Saturday night. But yeah, I'm hopeful, but I just don't see it right now.
You know what? Sometimes you gotta pull a muscle if you want to get to the top. She was dropping it so they could slay. That gives me hope. There is commitment here, people. I'm giving this a 7.5 because it is a guilty pleasure in a year that is somewhat sanitary, where people are perhaps trying too hard to be authentic. With Salvador, it was natural, but I think in some countries it's like, oh, we're going to be. It's more calculating, and so it doesn't necessarily work for me. Whereas this, they're owning what Ed would call trash. They're owning this Euro dance, and I'm hopeful this could be a borderline qualifier based on the memorability, based on that club feel. You know, I'm older, and it's giving me a vintage feel to the '90s. Heaven, hello. All right. That is what we think, but we are not the only Weeby bloggers around the world. There are people, dozens all over the place, and they have also given average scores out of 10, and the overall average is 6.58. So, you know, that's ahead of Denmark, an earlier video we published. So, well done, Slovenia. That's what we think. What do you think? Are you loving Leia? Is it a Vala Nay? A Vala Yay? A Vala Slay? Let us know here on Weeby Blogs.
Don't forget to lick.
Oh! Keep it. Nay, nay.
Like down below.
Add your comments, please.
And don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you get our videos the moment they come out.
We'll see you later. Bye!